The power to command the armed forces and raise a personal militia. She has the power to read confidential government documents and intelligence reports. The power to declare a state of emergency and issue proclamations. She has the power to call elections and enact laws in Her Majesty's name. Few people realize that not a single law is passed without the Queen's consent. She has the power to exercise crown prerogatives, which means the Queen can declare war through her Prime Minister without even the agreement of Parliament. She has the power to grant and bestow titles and honors like Sir, the power to pardon convicted criminals. So why has the Queen been allowed to legally possess all of these supreme powers? For the sake of tradition? Public land in the Queen's colonies like Canada is called Crown land and includes Aboriginal land. Government corporations are called Crown corporations. The Central Bank of Canada and the Canadian Mint are Crown corporations independent of most government controls. Canadian warships are called HMCS, Her Majesty's Canadian Ship, and in Australia they're called HMAS, Her Majesty's Australian Ship. Canada's National Police Force is called the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. All government contracts are between a company or individual and Her Majesty. Court summons are issued in the name of the Queen, and all public inquiries are called Royal Commissions. Commonwealth money carries the Queen's image worldwide as a reminder of her authority. The Queen is the lifetime hereditary head of state of Great Britain and her colonies and is unelected and unaccountable. It is against the law to advocate the abolition of the monarchy.
After the revolution, the French started calling her the lady, but in English, the queen is still the queen. Move. Originally in India, Persia, and Arabia, she was male and weak. But she changed sex in Europe in the Middle Ages and became the strongest of all chess pieces.
I hear the queen is powerful.
What is the cost to British taxpayers to support the Queen and her blue blood entourage? The Public Accounts Committee and National Audit Office are forbidden to examine Queen Elizabeth Windsor's family finances, the civil list payments, and the black slave trade. In 1977, the Bank of England nominees was established to hide the Queen's personal portfolio of wealth. As the British monarch, the Queen has access to privileged information, state secrets, and the world's top financiers. She is immune to accusations of insider trading or conflicts of interest. Her financial portfolio includes Rio Tinto, General Electric, Royal Dutch Shell, British Petroleum, Archer Daniels Midland, and the list goes on. The Queen's visible billions are but a tiny fraction of her invisible wealth accumulated through the black nobility. What is the black nobility? The black nobility is a wealthy aristocracy of elite ruling families who solidified their power in the 12th century by intermarrying with the wealthy godfather families of Venice, Italy. During the bloodbaths of the Christian Crusades, this brutal Italian oligarchy captured the trading monopolies. Over the centuries, the black nobility have used their power and wealth to rape, plunder, and exploit every corner of the globe. Dr. John Coleman's book, The Committee of 300, describes the history of assassinations, kidnappings, robbery, rape, blackmail, coercion, and terror committed by these inbred families on a grand scale. Today, they enrich themselves from the illegal drug and arms trade using well-distanced intermediaries. An estimated $280 billion in flight capital and drug money flows into their secret Swiss accounts. Who are these ruling black nobility families? They include the House of Hanover, Germany, the House of Habsburg, Austria, the House of Orange, Netherlands, the House of Liechtenstein and Liechtenstein, and most importantly, the House of Guelph in Britain. All of these family houses can be found on Queen Elizabeth II's family tree. The black nobility are the founders of the Committee of 300, which is also known as the Illuminati or Illuminated Ones. Queen Elizabeth II is head of the committee of these 300 ruling families. The Illuminati was formed to achieve one main objective, one world government called the New World Order. The masses will eventually be taught to bow down and worship this one world dictator who will rule the entire world from his eternal throne in Israel. The big question is, who is this charismatic leader that the entire world would be willing to accept as their ruler? According to plan, this future world ruler will prove himself to be a descendant of Jesus Christ and Mary Magdalene, and will therefore be accepted by the Christian world. Some will even view him as the Savior and Messiah. As a professed descendant of Christ and a proponent of world religion, he will also be accepted by Buddhists, Hindus, and the Eastern world, where Jesus Christ reportedly lived, studied, and preached Eastern philosophy. Since he is a descendant of the Hebrew tribes of Israel, he will also be accepted by Hebrews and Jews worldwide. By marrying a Muslim woman, he will win the acceptance of the Muslim world. He will also be accepted by worldwide Freemasonry and secret societies, which he is a member of. As the son of Princess Diana, he is already loved and worshipped. When his mother died in the arms of a Muslim man in a Paris car crash, the world embraced him. On May 31, 2004, the Rothschild-controlled Associated Press published a photograph worldwide taken by Alistair Grant. The photo shows Prince William posing with a lamb like Jesus Christ, who the Bible calls the Lamb of God. What is the significance of this photograph? To the unaware observer, the photograph is perfectly innocent, but to insiders familiar with the protocols of Zion, Freemasonry, and the Book of Revelation, William is identified in the photo as the Antichrist. The Antichrist has been described in art and literature as handsome and charming and a master of lies and deception. Freemasons call him the Baphomet, or Goat of Mendes. He has also been described as the embodiment of evil and the enemy of God, and has been called Satan, Lucifer, Pan, the Beast, and Amun. He is commonly illustrated with cloven hind hooves. Why is Prince William holding up a cloven hind hoof in the photograph? The question of whether God or Satan even exists has been fiercely debated since the beginning of debate. Some people believe that God and Satan are inventions of the ruling class to control the masses. Most people acknowledge the existence of positive creative energy characterized by joy, love, and vitality, and the existence of negative destructive energy characterized by greed, hatred, and death. The triumph of evil in the world today is based on the ability of evil to disguise itself as its opposite and fool the masses. According to Masonic calculations, Prince William is predicted to be crowned world dictator in the year 2015 at the age of 33. Without organized intervention, life and peace on earth will take on a whole new meaning.